Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to discuss a little bit about our second acoustic rule in the series. Then there's probably going to be 10 or so of these. And that's the speaker listening position in the room, kind of that power triangle as we call it. The speaker position and listening position in the room are critical. And you've got to get that right at the beginning before you do any kind of treatment. A lot of people like to put things where they're convenient. Well, the room really doesn't care about convenience. The room only cares about energy. So we know our speakers are energy-producing sources. So those energy-producing sources sound best when they're not contained in a room. Well, unfortunately, we have to live in rooms to shield us from the environment and things like that. So we have to realize that these energy-producing sources have to be positioned within the room. There's a spot in the room where they can work better than in certain other areas. We also have to remember that the sub is a huge low frequency producing energy source, and you just can't willy-nilly put it where you want to. The room will tell you where it needs to go. And I'll tell you this up front, we're gonna do a whole series on subwoofer placement, but sitting it on the floor is one of the worst things that you can do. But we'll talk about that later in other videos. The sub is a 360-degree radiating energy source, not just out of the driver. The whole cabinet radiates energy. And we're going to do a video on that shortly, too, to give you an idea. So these speakers and listening position kind of form this power triangle, if you will, okay? So we have to be very careful where we position this power triangle. And we have to view the whole thing as locked together. So if we move speakers up, we move speakers back, we move listening position up, we move listening position back. Let's start with the equilateral triangle situation. Our distances between the speakers should be equal to the distance to the listening position, okay? But this whole unit has to be considered a single unit and placed within our room size and volume. And there's a particular spot where these energy sources have a positive impact on the frequency response in the room, regardless of treatment. So even before we address any treatment issues, you know, we want to make sure that we're not creating this low-end bump here in the low end. We want to make sure that, you know, it's minimized as much as possible with proper positioning out of the gate. Then our treatment comes in after that. So we want to be very careful about where we put this. Where is the correct position? Well, it depends on the size of the room, the volume of the room. So the size of the drivers, the energy producing sources, how large are they? What is their diameter? How many do you have? So all of this has to be taken into consideration. So in line with our first rule, which is do no harm, we want to position our speakers in a position within the room, certain distance from the front wall, certain distance from the rear wall, that's in balance with the room size and dimensions of the room. And there are spots that work better than others. So our goal mainly is on the low end. We can deal with the middle and high frequencies, but our main purpose is not to accentuate, but attenuate this low frequency bump through proper speaker placement and listening position. And we can definitely have a frequency response impact by doing it. A popular way is the rule of thirds, where you take your room and you divide it in thirds and you put your speakers here and your listening position here. Good starting point in some room size and volumes, not in others. The smaller the room, the less this becomes a more viable situation. The larger the room, it gets closer to being true. But size does matter. Room size matters. Speaker size matters. Room volume matters. All of it has a direct impact on the frequency response of the room. So setting your speakers and listening position up that's where it's convenient may not be convenient for the room. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section, and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.